Hello everyone, welcome to my What We Need YouTube channel. Today our topic is biotechnology and its applications. Let us discussing about the biotechnology and its applications. Biotechnology essentially deals with industrial scale production of biopharmaceuticals and biologicals using genetically modified microbes, fungi, plants and animals. Now I am coming to the next point. In this way, biotechnology has great impact in therapeutics, diagnostics, genetically modified crops for agriculture, processed food, bioremediation, waste treatment and energy production. Now I will create a neat model question here. Biotechnology applications are first one, industrial scale production of biopharmaceuticals. Second option, biologicals using genetically modified microbes, fungi, plants and animals. Third option, therapeutics, diagnostics. Fourth option, all the above. Okay, here is fourth option is the right answer, all the above. Yes. Now I am coming to the next point. Three critical research areas of biotechnology are first one, searching and providing the best catalyst, in the form of improved organism, that is genetically modified eurochemicals. I will create a neat level statement question here. In green revolution, tripled crop production partly through development of high yielding varieties but mainly due to the use of better management practices and extensive use of agrochemicals. That is the true statement. Now I am asking incorrect statement. So that is, in green revolution, tripled crop production mainly due to the development of high yielding varieties but partly through the use of better management practices and extensive use of agrochemicals. Yes, that is the incorrect statement. Next point, at present in the developing world, using expensive agrochemicals and with existing varieties developed through conventional breeding by a farmer, further increase in yield is not possible. I will repeat again. At present in the developing world, using expensive agrochemicals and with existing varieties developed through conventional breeding by a farmer, further increase in yield is not possible. And next one, agrochemicals are harmful effects on environment and there is a limit of breeding high yielding varieties through conventional methods. Next, I am coming to the next one, organic agriculture. Second one, organic agriculture. So in organic agriculture, cannot enhance crop yield to any appreciable degree. This is possible only when crop plants genetically modified to increase quality and quantity of food materials. I will repeat again. Organic agriculture cannot enhance crop yield to any appreciable degree. This is possible only when crop plants genetically modified to increase quality and quantity of food. Now I am coming to the next point, that is the third application of agriculture. So that is the genetically engineered crop based agriculture. What is the genetically engineered crop based agriculture? So in genetically engineered crop based agriculture, so it is not possible through conventional breeding methods. It is not genetic engineering crop based agriculture. It's not possible through conventional breeding methods. So here conventional breeding program are time consuming process. So here conventional breeding programs are time consuming process. Transgene. Here, what is the transgene? Here, what is the transgene? Transgene. The gene transferred to another organism artificially by technique of genetic engineering is called transgene. And plants with desirable characters develops in a gene transfer methods is called transgenic plants or genetically modified plants or genetically modified organisms.